So I live in The Hague, which is a city near the beach in the Netherlands. It's kind of a triangle with Rotterdam, Amsterdam and The Hague. It's not a very big city. We have about 500,000 people living there. For example, if I walk my dog at the beach in the morning, there's only 5 people walking there. So it's not a very busy city, which also is the reason why I think most creatives choose Rotterdam or Amsterdam to live and work. But I very much enjoy that The Hague is more affordable, which allows me to travel a lot and to go to Berlin, to Paris, to outside of Europe too, of course. And also the price of renting a studio is very much affordable, which means you don't have to share a studio with 9 people. You can actually very much concentrate, have peace of mind and focus on what you're doing. As I mostly work on freelance illustration assignments, and if I paint in my studio, which can basically be anywhere, I'm very much playing with the idea of moving to Australia because my girlfriend's from Australia, and I feel I'm living in the same city for 11 years now, while my work allows me to basically work from any location on earth. So I feel I'm not using that enough, but I do like living in a quiet city, so I have peace of mind, I can concentrate on what I'm doing, I can focus. And then in the weekends I can go anywhere I want. I can go to Amsterdam all the time if there's something fun going on. But I'm not really focused on one day I'm going to live in New York and be amongst all the big creatives and where there's people from all over the world in one big city. I very much am familiar with the people working there. I do my homework, I know what's going on. But I feel the moment I'm living amongst them, I probably go to all openings, to all parties, to all curative happenings, and then I feel it's going to distract me a little bit from actually work on my own paintings, for example. There is this delay in sending emails out and in chatting, because you send a text message out and you get a reply maybe the next day or in 1 hour or in 2 hours. And so it makes having conversations difficult. It's like mostly monologues. It's somebody sending information to someone and then somebody replying on that. Oh, for example, if you have an eye-to-eye conversation, you can actually, have a way faster way of communicating. So that will always have my preference. I teach about 40 students in my drawing classes, and I really enjoy looking at them, talking with them, and I have these conversations, these discussions, assessments. And right now I have the idea, imagine if that's digital, and that would be, horrible. Yeah. What I enjoy about teaching is that I can teach the things that I wish I learned when I was at art school. And when I was studying, for example, I wasn't really one of the best students. I was always late. I felt very insecure. I didn't really know what to do and what graphic design was. I remember that I worked on projects the night before the deadlines. So I'm very much into making sure my students have time to work on projects, and that I make sure that the moment I see that they're stuck, that I'm like, hey, maybe go this way, maybe try this. And the things that I very much enjoyed hearing when I was studying.